नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इंडिविजुअल्स इन वेरियस फॉर्मेट्स एंड इंडिविजुअल्स इन मेडिकल फ्रैटर्निटी, स्पेसिफिकली दिस इज फॉर मेडिकल फ्रैटर्निटी, आर्ट एंड कल्चर फ्रैटर्निटी एंड समवन हु इज प्रैक्टिसिंग योगा एंड मेडिटेशन एज अ पार्ट ऑफ देयर डेली रिलीजन. यू कैन से इट एज द फर्दर एक्सटेंशन ऑफ माई प्रीवियस वीडियोज एज टू हाउ एग्जैक्टली द शास्त्रास were transcribed using the Shrutis to Smritis, understanding the in-depth understanding of Ananda and Paramananda state or Soham, Hamsa Soham state or Paramahamsa state. I was bit disturbed, to be frank, reason is we need to look at it in a more broader sense. Today yoga means most of us are thinking as if it's only with regards to asana or whatever it is as such. No, it's not that case, ladies and gentlemen. Understand this. This is high time that one needs to understand. Yesterday I was hearing to Rock Schwartz talk in Zoom. He was talking about souls. At one point he was telling that he had a live example of speaking to the souls, or he gave some examples and they got reformed and they came back to material world. First thing is first, one who gets to the highest realms, let's say to the highest level of understanding, that is between Nitya and Anitya, he would be in the Ananda and Paramananda state. Unfortunately, today people think that to reach to that Ananda and Paramananda state or Soham or Hamsa Soham state or Paramahamsa state, which very few philosophers or very few seers like Ramana Maharshi, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, Swami Vivekananda and other realized souls could reach. And they had a very different viewpoint, and they were not into this material world as such, because they could have that clear distinction, they could draw lines. In fact, unfortunately, today yoga is being taken in its wrong state of mind. I'm getting forced to say this, by the way. I see Sahaja Yoga, I see pyramid coming into picture, I see other type of yoga, other type of meditational practices and all. The point is, we are forgetting on cleansing of panchakoshas or panchendriyas or the panchabhutas that are there in our body. First thing is first, one needs to understand this point that panchakoshas or panchendriyas or panchabhutas need to be cleansed to get to that state of mind. It's not that it comes just like that. It requires a lot of meditational practices and lot of penance, patience and perseverance is required for this. There is no shortcut for that at first place. At the same time, I was hearing to the cross discussion with Dr. Ranade, a neurosurgeon. He had that valid justification to whatever that he did and whatever that he was speaking. Maybe due to understanding of what exactly the spiritual practices or spiritual ritualistic practices are all about. And if one says this subject is stipulated to this only, ladies and gentlemen, I am extremely sorry to say this, it pertains to even art and cultural form also, classical dance form specifically, because before even coming to Natya Shastra, in Shastras, this has been clearly explained in depth and in deeper aspect as I was speaking about in my previous videos. That's the reason why I told this is the further extension to it. And most importantly, it pertains to the conscious state and subconscious state activation level. Though I don't know about pineal glands activation, but this pineal gland or the pineal it's a kind of energy, I would rather say. It happens in the body. It helps one to understand or take the signals from subconscious level to the mind, right and left side of the brain. This is just an idea that I have. However, I would be speaking in length with Dr. Ranade as to how exactly this works. Because once we try to understand how exactly this gets activated, he or she, whoever is practicing or trying to take those signals from the universe. As we know, as I was speaking, our body can take up to the vibrations or the science of sound which comes into picture 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. That concept also comes into picture. Now, coming to the point of what exactly is this yoga maya, yoga. Yoga means it's like traveling between space and time. The amount of time that requires for an individual to travel between space and time requires a lot of time, because one needs to understand Anu and Paramanu concept. Anu means atom. Paramanu means subatom. We have so many things involved in that. I don't know, but Dr. Ranade sir had that clear-cut idea, and he could justify that with a proper explanation. This is not the case with Westerners like Bob Proctor or Rob Schwartz, wherein they are giving just their way of understanding things. And unfortunately, I see this, that we are getting, we as an individual, that includes me as well, getting succumbed to the fact that this is correct. But this is not correct, ladies and gentlemen. The practical phenomena or the structured or schematic way of getting to Ananda or Paramananda or Soham or Hamsa Soham or Paramahamsa state is cleansing your Panchendriyas or Panchendriyas and Panchabhutas, which practically happen in classical dance because they have certain structure and scheme. And fortunately, there are a couple of scholars who really followed this, who are late Dr. Vedantam Satyanarayan Sharmagaru and Dr. Vempati Chinna Satyam Master Garu. They had that clear-cut vision. They had that clarity. They had understood that. And that's the way they have trained even their students. Yesterday I had a very rare opportunity to see that glimpse of training which Master Garu had given to his student from US. It was really overwhelming, and it was a treatise to see that she was in such a Ananda and Paramananda state that she could put every gesture, she could deploy all kinds of systematic and schematic approach while performing or while showing that practical application. It was really heartwarming to see that. Now, the reason for talking about that in the second phase, and firstly I was talking about neurosciences from the scientific point of view. What one needs to understand is, be it an individual, non-performer, or individual who is pursuing meditation and yoga practices as a ritual and religion, has to really go through all of this. It was really treatise to see that the brain function or the neurofunctions, I could see from the scientific point of view, which neurosurgeon explained and the Westerners have explained and the dancer had explained. Maybe she may have known about it or she may not have known about it, but I could clearly see that happening with her. My point over here is, don't get carried away with understanding yoga in shortcut methods, because when you travel in space and time, when a body starts traveling in space and time, it requires some time. In fact, lot of time. It requires, you know, quite a bit of time to actually like get accustomed. Because this deha, once it goes to the trance level, it's only the soul that travels. And coming to the point of speaking point, soul speaking to other soul, it only happens at soham hamsa soham state or paramhamsa state, or when Atman and Paramatman converge together and form as a Paramatman, Jivatman. This Jivatma gets unified with the universal fact. Understand this. This is very important aspect for everyone, for every individual. This is the beauty of our shastras. And fortunately, we have legendary gurus who have implemented that and practically tried it out, and they could show that, and they have been torchbearers for the same. My point over here is, why are we getting carried away with the shortcut methods? This is not a question to dancers or classical dancers or classical musicians, but maybe this could be a kind of study or a kind of open-ended question that if a dancer asks for himself or herself, what is it that he is doing, he or she is doing? The point is, I am not trying to demean anyone over here, even Bob Proctor or Rob Schwartz for that. Because Westerners could understand that way. And there are very few people who could understand that. It's just a gesture, and it's just my observation that I got. I would rather put it that way. It's just my observation that I could understand. If classical dance or dancers who are thinking this is the for entertainment purpose need to think once, twice, thrice, even 100 times before even getting into what you call complacency mode. Fine, let me learn just for the sake of learning. No, this is the in-depth understanding. This is the actual application, or this is the actual way of understanding a dance form, art and culture form, classical dance form, wherein the practical applications of cleansing of panchakoshas or panchendriyas or end panchabhutas happen. And once they reach to that level, the further advanced level would be Navavarna. That happens with the dancer. And the same thing in the medical field, from the scientific front, if we say, we talk from the Anu and Paramanu concept, electrons, protons, neutrons and nuons concept, touching that mind, conscious and subconscious level. Though it's not a one-day practice or it's not a two-day practice, it comes only through penance, meditation and thorough understanding about soul, soul's journey. What is soul? Does that really exist? Can it be created? Can it be destroyed? How the thoughts happen? How do we cleanse that? Why do we need to cleanse that? I'm giving this example of medical practitioners. I was seeing a pyramid, I was watching that video. Why should one individual thrust himself to get that laughter? Is my point. Because Ananda and Paramananda state is such a state, it comes by default. It comes by default. It should come naturally. It has to. Or else, whatever that state that they have, Sahaja Yoga or Pyramid or whatever that practice that they are doing, it's not worthwhile. It's worthless. It doesn't stay for a longer time. And that is one reason why old rishis, munis and Brahma rishis had that intuition mind. And that is one reason why those Shrutis got transcribed to Smritis. Smritis transcribed to four Vedas. Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Atharvana Veda and Sama Veda. And this again in various other branches. And thus this in a way created as a stories, and this was presented in the form of classical dance form, which gives multi functions, like from the entertainment perspective, from the ailment perspective, from the happiness perspective. The real happiness is getting to the state of Ananda, Paramananda state, Soham and Hamsa Soham state, Paramahamsa state. This is what one needs to understand. This is just like, I just wanted to give a brief introduction about it. Thus I conclude this video with a positive note and pointers being, understanding the true meaning of Ananda and Paramananda, Soham and Hamsa Soham state, understanding Prakriti and Purusha very importantly, and there are no shortcuts. It requires practice, 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 penance. Unless and until you practice these panchakoshas or panchendriyas, panchakoshas, panchendriyas and panchabhutas will not get cleansed up. It doesn't happen in shortcuts time. Thus I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Shri Guru Bhyo Namah. Have a nice day ahead. May the Guru's grace be with all.